All right. Finally, it's autumn time, folks. It's autumn. Yay. Brought out the handmade wool blanket coat that I made. All of you seen this before? This has been quite a while. I haven't broke this guy on a long time. Actually, there's some cool upgrades to this. I can even tighten the sleeves up a little. Little Canadian jam knots right here inside the sleeves. So you, when you just cut that draft out, you just tighten them down. Closes right up. We're already in September 10th, 2007. Oh, did everybody see the koi hat? This is done by Mohammed Ayad. Let's give Mohammed. Hey, you see the palace koi right there? Can you see it with the tonga mark there? And then, of course, you have the second kiwi. All right, let's get to our announcements today. Welcome anybody who is here for the first time or joining us online to the sanctuary. Also, we have Freedom Society seminars. Our next seminar will be held Thursday, September 14th. Join us for another engaging session led by Kukshim. That's this week, right? This week, September 14th. Thank you, Mohammed. Thank you, Mohammed. Look at this. Very nice. Hey, brother. Thank you. Pretty cool. In our last meeting, we watched and discussed a documentary on the situation in Venezuela. It was shocking to see how people in that country plea for freedom as they struggle to secure even the basic necessities of life. Venezuela, Argentina, some of the most prosperous Latin American countries when they had freedom. But then, again, the archangel tempted, and poisoned the society with socialism, communism, you name it. And now it's become a totally imploded, backwards, people literally hunting dogs and animals on the street because there is no more things to steal. There's no more money to get. And, you know, the entire economies, both in Argentina and Venezuela, completely been taken over by dictators and has become completely political Satanist. Very, very sad. That was at the last meeting. Our next seminar will be held Thursday, September 4th at the Carms Factory, Lawrence Valley, PA, 7 p.m. So join Kukjinim and everybody else there. Also, Fireside Testimonies, September 15th with GNM will be speaking. Hey, September 15th. Friday evening at 7:30 p.m. Come hear testimonies about the King of Kings. This is a reminder of our special gathering at Bluestone Farms. Please arrive at 7 p.m. if you wish to bring your own beverage and chair, but no food, please. And of course, there is the address to Bluestone Farms. Camp video, the very late camp video. All right, let's play it. If there's an open way, I'll just run. While everything else fades and turns to dust, we're searching to find a way from here. We'll follow our souls into the night. Let's disappear, 'cause wherever we go, love is. And all the things kind of like Kendra teaches us, like self-defense, bushcrafting, and, you know, firearms training. All these kind of things are all about having freedom and being sovereign. Ballistic firearms, for example. If you never shot a firearm and you're scared to use one, then Satan can use that fear to control you. Just like Gary does everybody now, the government. They say, like, you can't trust people with these deadly weapons, so you have to do it to us. So you have this fear. I see that you have this fear, so I can control you with this fear. So whenever we're doing all these things, it's all about breaking your concepts of fear.
Working for being prepared for any kind. This is really awesome. This is, again, this is the center of it all in this camp. And I'm actually really ecstatic about this. You know, because here's the thing, right? We are stepping in to what God has always wanted to give us, what God has always wanted us to realize, while at the same time giving a big middle finger to the archangel. Because why? Because Satan wants you to not realize your sovereignty and always wants to take that away from you, right? Those of you who are couples, you wear your crowns and you wear them proud. Yeah, couples?
Yeah.
All right. For those of you who are single, you're honoring your future spouse and you're honoring your parents who you want to offer that crown to. You hold that crown. You don't wear that crown. You hold it, right? An absolute honor to your future spouse or your king and your queen, your mother and your father. You guys got that, singles?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Let's thank our king and our queen once again.
Is the greatest blessing of God. The blessing is the greatest blessing. Remember, the blessing is not called happiness. For a reason, God does, even the Bible, the whole Bible, that God never promises married couples happiness. He doesn't say, my goal is to give you happiness. That's a pagan teaching. The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says, God will give you blessing in marriage. But sometimes blessings can be hard. Sometimes blessings can get on your nerve. Sometimes blessings can, but if you understand what that is, then you'll realize as the time goes on what a blessing that person is. The best thing is to allow yourself to be completely open to God. Right? When I was blessed, I said, no, Father, I don't care. I don't care who it is. I will be victorious, whoever. I have complete confidence. Nobody will defeat me. I'll be absolutely victorious in blessing. I don't care who it is. It doesn't matter. I told Father that. He was so happy. He was so happy. Because I wanted to get blessed. There was this stupid, crazy culture. Oh, you're getting blessed. Oh, you poor thing, you're being blessed. Oh, you're so poor. Oh, you're really, yeah, I know you don't want to get blessed. Oh, you're so poor. This kind of crazy, why would you do that? Why would you do that? You're sabotaging yourself. Why would you do that? You're suicidal if you do that. It's like going into some kind of, you know, jujitsu match. It's like, I'm gonna lose, 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 I'm losing, I'm losing, I'm losing, I'm gonna lose, 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 everybody pray for me, I'm gonna lose. That's exactly what you're doing. Why would you do that? It's insane. It's totally insane. Why not do the opposite and say, I'm gonna be victorious, I'm gonna win, I'm gonna be victorious. It's gonna be a win, 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 win. Because not only me gonna win, she's gonna win, kids gonna win, everybody who touches, who gets in, our presence gonna win. Why not put it that way?
With what did Jesus bring Satan to his knees? He subjugated him with heaven's principle of love. You have to understand this. What we Christians have to understand today is that the only thing that works in subjugating Satan is the principle of love.
The only thing that occupied Jesus' mind, his only thought, was subjugating Satan and substantiating God's will on that foundation. He led a life in which he felt this responsibility to his bones. There was not a moment when Jesus forgot this responsibility.
This is one of the origins of how blessed children fall. Their path to being absolute children is being clouded by Satan and his tricks. Satan could tempt you with a slut or a hoe any day. Satan, to me, the archangel is one of the biggest players on this whole board. And this is just how Satan works. This is how Satan makes species fall. He takes each of us one by one to do whatever he wants. He will slip through every crack in your faith that he can find, and he can take advantage of it. But absolute sex is when Satan has nothing to do with you. Nothing to do with your sex, nothing to do with your family. And that's what God really wanted us all to do. Your lineage rests on your shoulders, and you're gonna let Satan and his temptation ruin this all for you? This beautiful gift God gave us all.
Secondly, absolute sex is a sex that we can proclaim that we are the child of God.
If you think about it, sex is everything in this world, everything for humankind. Without sex, none of the great men and women who shaped the world would have lived. None of the men and women in the Bible who have shaped providence for the Messiah to return would have never lived. God's plan would have never worked. And with that, this is why absolute sex is so important. Absolute sex is important because of the lineage. The lineage is the seed of Christ that God has spent thousands of years trying to perfect. True Father stated that the power of absolute sex under God was enough to silence Satan, was enough to make him submit to him, to make that liar, that pathetic thief of his children, of his joy, submit. That is what Father has done for us. And only the blessed child has the ability to rebuke Satan, because the blessed child comes from absolute sex.
What are you doing to each other? I used to live like I was in a deck, darling, nails from my past. I had no hope for tomorrow. Felt so much pressure, yes, I thought I would crack. But now I'm just going to give you a day to go. I'm leave. Get out of here. Get out of my face. And now I know fear, no doubt, can't shoot me down. Yeah, I got my arm, but now I know fear, no doubt.
gonna shoot me down, 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 down. All right, and there you go. That was Camp 2017. Pointer, please. Thank you. Also, HSU, Holy Spirit University 2017 fall registration is open. Sign up at sanctuary-pa.org. Click on the HSU tab and sign up for classes that are now in session. Here we go, fall classes. We're going to have everybody come down. Is that right, Carrie?
Really quick.
Okay, really quick. Come down, come on down, guys, if you're in the area, if you're in the sanctuary today. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. I know time is short, so I just want to say I'll be leading a class entitled Love and Respect. I won't talk about it because it's right in the catalog, the description. But this is going to be on-site only, so it'll be held in Greeley. I think at my home. We'll see how many people we have. If I can fit it at home, we'll do it at home. So for you brothers here in our community, we all know many of our wives last semester took the class with Yana, and I know you've grown in your faith and through that scriptural life word. Now, brothers, let's step up our games, okay? So join with me. We're going to grow in God's word.
Thank you, Lowell. Andrew Derricott is leading an online class entitled Connecting Christianity with the Lord at His Second Coming. And together with him in this class, you'll be looking at the red part of the Exposition of the Divine Principle. That's Andrew Derricott, online class. Next, we have Christy McKenna, who is going to be leading Preparedness Peace. For six semesters, Arthur Noren led Preparedness Peace, but now Christy will be leading it, and she'll be using the same materials and giving everyone really practical preparedness guidance on how to deal with any difficult situation that may come. Next, we have The Purpose-Driven Life in Russia, given by Tatiana Nguizi.
Этот класс будет строиться на книге Рика Уоррена «Целеустремленная жизнь», и он поможет обновить осознание себя как Божьих детей, у которых жизнь не случайная, но у которых есть цель в соответствии с Божьим планом. Через этот класс мы станем более похожи на Христа, обновим свои отношения с Богом и сможем справиться с ситуациями стресса, и доставить больше радости Богу и быть более удовлетворенными в своей жизни.
Thank you, Valia. Michelle Beauvais is going to lead an online class in French on the letter of Paul to the Romans.
Oui, cette classe est ouverte à tous les frères et sœurs francophones à travers le monde, et nous allons partager sur la lettre de Paul aux églises de Rome après sa conversion à Damas. L'apôtre Paul avait beaucoup de questions de foi et de sa relation avec Jésus-Christ, et nous allons approfondir notre foi en étudiant ces textes. Donc cette classe est à 8h p.m., 20h p.m. En France, et 2h au temps de la côte ouest, au côte est, New York.
Thank you, Pierre. Yananim is giving love and respect again, but this time for our Korean sisters.
Today it's like an international class. It's international congregation is everybody's here. This time I'm teaching love and respect class in Korean. 예, 한국말로. 네, 이번에 사랑과 존경 가르칩니다. 온라인으로 가르치고요. 관심 있는 분들은 온라인으로 등록해 주시면 되겠습니다. 우리 이대왕님께서 많이 강조하시고 항상 그 말씀하시는 사랑과 존경. 네, 저희 축복 가정도 해봅시다. 네.
Thank you, my beloved queen. Sonja Park in Korea is going to be leading Let's Study the Constitution of Chung Il-guk with the Holy Spirit. That's Sunja Park.
皆さん、こんにちは。今回聖書を学ぼうという精霊大学を開きます、コウミキと言います。私のクラスでは聖書の創世記からヨハネの黙示録までの基本的な内外の知識を学んでいきます。そして聖書の時代別の歴史的、政治的、地理的な 背景を学びながら聖書の歴史に一貫して流れる神様の意思と、そして愛を学んでいく予定です。また希望者を募り、聖書の一読も並行して行う予定です。クラスはもちろん LINE でのメンバーでの交流を通して精霊の導きを毎回感じます。聖書を初めて読むという方も大歓迎ですので、多くの方々の参加をお待ちしています。よろしくお願いします。
Thank you, Mickey. Mickey's leading her class on I Know Nothing About the Bible, but by now she knows quite a bit about the Bible. Now, this is Mrs. Park. 네.
안녕하십니까. 반갑습니다. 예, 저희는 지난 학기에 성경 그 구약을 중심 삼고 성경대학을 했었습니다. 근데 이번에는 천일국 헌법에 대해서 저희가 가까이 접하고 함으로써 좀 더 깊이 또 관심을 가질 수 있는 그런 동기를 마련하고자 천일국 헌법에 대해서 공부를 하기로 했습니다. 그래서 지금 많은 사람들이 관심을 가지고 있고 저 자신도 그 헌법 공부를 좀 열심히 해야지 될 것 같아가지고 이번에 그 천일국 헌법을 하는데 뭐 여러 가지 좀 의문되고 하는 그런 점을 많을 때는 제가 잘 모르기 때문에 질문해 가면서 열심히 하도록 하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
Thank you, Mrs. Park. Nobuo Mizutani is leading a class in Japanese on More Than a Carpenter.
More Than a Carpenter, 大工さんよりも 日本語では神か大かっていうタイトルがついております。この著者は、作者はもともと神様を信じない無神論者でありましたけれども、学生時代キャンパスにおいてクリスチャンのキリスト教の教授たちを批判したり、あるいはイエスキリストを信じる学生たち友達を軽蔑していたんですけれども、 いろんな面から常識的な面から検証することによって、イエス様は偉大なキリストであるという結論に到達することになりました。神様を迎え入れて、そしてイエスキリストを通じて神様が創造された本来の自分自身の価値を見出し、その喜びを感じるようになったということですね。このクラスの目的は この聖書原理講論の御言葉、そしてこの本を通してメシアにつながり神様と親密な親子の関係を築くことがこのクラスの目的です。イエスキリストを知ることによって、再臨の主として来られたお父様のメシアとしての本来の目的、そしてその価値 内容をさらに深く学ぶことができるでしょう。アメリカ、カナダ、サウスアメリカ、オシアナ、コリア、ジャパン、アンド、アフリカ、全世界でご苦労されている日本の兄弟姉妹の皆様、ズームでお会いしたいと思います。待っています。
I tell you that God's word is like a mustard seed. Yeonanim taught to us love and respect in English, and now she's teaching it in Korean. Lowell's teaching it to men, and Akemi-san is teaching it to Japanese brothers and sisters. Love and respect.
Konnichiwa. ては、明美グエンと言います。前回ヨナニムと一緒にそのラブ&リスペクトを本当に共に学ぶことができまして、本当にすごく多くの恩恵を受けました。それで今回は足りないながらも、日本語で本当に日本の、姉妹たちと共にこの内容を学ばさせていただきたいと思います。でこれは特にエマーソン・エガリクさんによる愛と尊敬ということで、エペソ人の5章33節に夫たちは尊敬を必要とし、そして妻たちは愛を必要とするという、その内容を本当に中心として神様を中心としたさまざまなそういう抱えているその結婚生活において、あるいは祝福家庭という立場において、それを解決していくための本当に一つのまた道を示してくれていて、本当に感動しました。ですからぜひ共に学んでいきたいと思われる方はぜひ来られてください。参加してください。どうもありがとうございます。
Thank you, Kanako. I have to say there are 16 classes this semester. 9 of them are in Japanese. So once again, our Japanese brothers and sisters are leading the way. I'm about to turn over the microphone to Hitoshi, who's going to introduce the last 6 classes. I want to give a special thanks to Kanako Muramatsu, who's really helping to coordinate this. We have Hitoshi's going to give his constitution class again. We have Kaori Suhara, Biblical Educational Principles for Parents and Children. We have Toshiko Utake, let's read the Gospel of Matthew together. Harumi Masabuchi, let's enjoy the New Testament. And we have Yukari Ida, looking at current events using the Bible. And we have Takeshi Iwamoto, the study of the Constitution of Chungilguk. So here's Hitoshi saying it in Japanese.
本当にたくさんのクラスがありまして、手短にお話しします。日本語で学ぶ天一国憲法、私がやります。オンラインのみです。天一国憲法の基本的な理解を深めるということと、説明できるようになるということです。次行きましょう。親と子のための聖書的教育原理、須原香織さん、これは韓国ですね、でやります。そして、この目的は聖書を中心として神様と私の関係、そして家族との関係を取り戻していく回復治療プログラムをやるということです。よろしくお願いします。それから、もう一つは、マタイ福音書を共に読もうということで、大竹敏子さん、ユダヤ人を対象に書かれたマタイ福音書を読んで、ユダヤの文化を学びます。それから、すごいな。ですね、これも韓国ですね。聖書に親しもう、新約聖書を中心として、増渕晴美さんのクラスです。イエス様の生涯、そして弟子たちの宣教ともに聖書を読みながら進め、原理との関連性を詳しく、捉えていきます。よろしくお願いします。それから、すごいね。ロットブ。ロットブクラス。天一国憲法がもう一つありました。はい。日本の、兄弟、岩本武史さんがやります。天一国憲法の、やはり外観の理解を目指していきます。ヒョンジン様、クチ様の御言葉を原点に、基本的な理解を深めていきます。はい。さらに日本の井田ゆかりさんがやります。聖書を使って今を考えてみようということで、お父様の原点である聖書の御言葉、歴史に立ち返って今の観難の時を一緒に考えてみませんかということで、ディベート中心のクラスになります。それで終わりかなですね。はい。
OK。Thank you very much.
Just a real quick sentence on my class, Love and Respect for Men. I wanted to emphasize, not only blessed brothers, but you young guys, as you're preparing for the blessing, if you're starting to think about the blessing,
get this information, it'll solve you some heartache, I think, along the way, because we all know that it's not a, you know, it takes our 100% effort and faith to be to make a successful family. So yeah, young guys, come on.
Thank you, Lo. Thank you, everyone. Sign up. Let the Holy Spirit fill your heart.
Amen. All right, thank you, HSU and Carrie and everybody. DP Education and Witnessing, interested in witnessing and divine principle education, there will be a meeting today, 2 p.m. in the small sanctuary led by Carrie Williams, Sanctuary Church USA Education Director. Also, Kingdom Gospel Bible Study, that's here at Sanctuary, Wednesdays at 7 p.m., ongoing with Bill Brunhofer and Lowell Ellenson. Where's Lowell and Bill? Yeah, there you go. Hey, there you go, there you go. Wow, see, I see all these beautiful crowns today. Everybody's standing in their sovereignty. Now remember, they may start as, you know, Amazon.com crowns or Walmart crowns, that. But as time goes on, they become substantial, real. Right? And like, you know, you heard Father talking, how many heard Father talking on Thursday? Oh, praise God, praise God. It's not the gold that makes the crown, the king. The king makes the crown. The king and his, who he is what creates that foundation, okay? And so it's so important that the Chinigo, citizen of Chinigo understand that kind of sovereignty and that kind of kingship mentality. And of course, we're going to be studying that, of course, in the Bible studies and everywhere. In between, this week is Paul's second letter to the church in Corinth. Paul says, we are the fragrance of Christ among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. For if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. A new creation. Garage sale next Sunday. Please donate your unwanted yet still good items to sell. Please contact Luz Franco or Layla Johnson for more details. Luz, raise your hand. Layla, where are you? Did she go? Where's Layla? Okay, so talk to these queens over here if you need some in more information about the garage sale. Also, Ocean Challenge, Georgetown, Maine. New dates, October 2nd through 7th. Been delayed for about one week back. Register by September 17th. $200 for the week for the couples and families. Campers will be responsible for their food, transportation, and camping gear. And, of course, the famous Maine Lobster Feast is going to be happening there. So, October 2nd through 7th. Video clip competition, 3 to 10 minutes clips of the Second King. Do we have one today? And now, you said it's going to be one every week, Greg, is that right? So there'll be signed constitutions every week. And then at the end of the year, there's going to be, I guess, a big prize, right? And we have judges for that. Who's the judges for that? Do you know? We have three judges for that, okay? And so do we have a clip now from our second entry? Go ahead, play that clip.
Welcome back to the King's Report this Tuesday, August 22nd, 2017. Broadcasting live from the Chinese Moon Palace. I'm your host, Hyung Sean Moon, the Second King of Chinese Moon.
They're mentally ill. In a cult, they literally don't know what planet they're living on. They think they're fighting the Klingons or something. They're living in Star Trek rerun episodes, watching Star Wars on replay VHS videos.
This is Antifa, this is about Antifa, okay?
In the background, thinking they're badass. They say war is peace. They agree with our enemies. Peace through violence. War is peace. You are the antagonist. Stupid idiots! Talking about, I got an AK-47, and this is the hole where the clip goes in. It's ridiculous!
Clip goes in.
Look at these riled up, lunatic, brainwashed white kids that have gone to overpaid schools, have useless degrees, debt, slavery, and are told the problems of that is because of Donald Trump and white supremacists. When it's the Marxist professors that have screwed them. Look how pathetic they are.
totally dishonorable idiots bring gas masks and clubs to free speech rallies where there's non-violent protests. Give me a break! We're totally grassroots. We're totally grassroots. We're not funded by George Soros. We're totally grassroots. And then every single person on the staff is funded by George Soros.
Hey, wow. Wow. Dang, that was amazing. Now, a Japanese brother did that. Isn't that amazing? Japanese guy in Japan did that. So we'll be sending the Constitution to him. Thank you, brother. Whoever did that, that was hilarious. That was so good. Boy, we're really looking forward to all these other ones that are coming in. You got to up that? Try to up that one. Boy, that was a good one. All right, let's go to the next slide now. Also, pre-order your Queen of Chunhyuguk Word and Brush series, signed limited edition prints from online store and sanctuary store. Of course, each one of these has the scripture that is related to the picture. Sample prints at Sanctuary Library Store. See Greg Knoll for more details, the Word and Brush series. Also, we must be praying for natural disaster victims. We just were hit in the U.S. With Harvey, and again, this time around with Irma, still in a state of emergency, that is, Florida is. I heard that hopefully our sanctuary people and everybody who knew about this in advance have moved out of the danger zone. But of course, there's a lot of rebuilding to do after these type of disasters. Please pray for the victims in these natural disasters. These are natural disasters that have happened just this month. We had Hurricane Jose, Katia, 8.1 on the Richter scale earthquake in Mexico, Typhoon Hato in Hong Kong, and Tropical Storm Pakar in Macau. So, of course, the U.S. is dealing with Irma right now. It's interesting because at the time of natural disaster, the country has to pull together and come together. You know, the leftist lunatics and the Antifa and the brainwashed children cannot do their insane asylum behavior on the streets and attack, you know, normal law-abiding people. The natural disaster creates an atmosphere where everybody has to pull together and try to, you know, help whoever's hurt. And this was so amazing, even at Harvey and Irma, people have prepared earlier. You had people who were really, constantly being beat down. In Harvey, for example, you had the hunters and the fishermen and their mossy oak camo and their, you know, going and rescuing people, you know, and the people that are really the flyover country of America that have the Christian values. Of course, they're becoming a minority, but they're always told that they're racist and bigoted and they're, you know, xenophobic and they should be killed by the leftist lunatics. But you see that on display, and even CNN and the mainstream propaganda, fake news media has to cover the normal good people of all creeds, colors, and races. It doesn't matter. They're helping everybody. And that's the real America. It's not the painted, you know, CNN pictures of America and Antifa doesn't represent America and all these nutbag Marxist professors in college, you know, colleges brainwashing students do not represent America. It is the bow hunter, the archer, the gun owner. It is the fisherman. It is the blue-collar worker that works hard and puts their neck on the line when there's disasters like this or any other time to go save people. And that really is the heart of the Christian. That is the heart of a Christ-centered country. Of course, that's dwindling in, you know, on the eve of post-Christian culture and multiculturalism and all the relativism that we've seen throughout the decades now creating and coming to a battle front. We are really on the battleground now, because if these disasters, you know, if these natural disasters, typhoons, hurricanes were not happening, we'd already be, there'd be more Antifa riots, fights, all sorts of stuff all over the country. They've been planning that since before the summertime to start civil war here in America. So there's always it's always a double-edged sword. There's a lot of disaster, et cetera. But again, people come together and they transcend the brainwashing, they transcend the Satanism, they transcend the political, you know, cultists and the centralists and the globalists and the Satanists that are always telling them, trying to divide them from the normal goodness of people. So we see this, so we have to pray for the people down there. If you can help in any way, the victims of Irma or Harvey, please do so. But of course, everybody needs their prayers down there. And the country needs to pull together. This is a serious, serious time. We're on the verge of nuclear war with North Korea. We're on the, you know, Iran is amping up their nuclear power capabilities, etc. This is not a playtime that we're living in. And meanwhile, this whole country is trying to be imploded by international bankers like Soros and the Rothschild Group and these fake political Satanists who think they're kings and queens. No, it is the children of God that are the true inheritors of the kingdoms of this world. And that's why it's so important to stand in your sovereignty. And yes, let people mock you and laugh at you with your crowns. Let them laugh at you. Ah, ha, ha, they're wearing crown. They got a $5 crown on. So what? Because in one generation, two generation, that will become real jewels and real gold and real representation of sovereignty. And it's so important to start leaving that slave mentality, leaving that servant mentality, as God now is calling us into his kingship, right? As we face and now are awaiting his kingdom that is quickly coming. So please pray for the victims down there, you know, down in Florida now. We hope that our sanctuaries down there can help anyone in that region. And of course, evacuate if they're in the danger zones. Do not listen to Democratic mayors who tell you to stay in place and that emergency notifications are ridiculous. Don't listen to them. You saw what happened in Harvey. You see what they always do. Also, join us for the King's Report Monday through Saturday, 5 a.m. to 8 a.m. Join us on King for inspiration and understanding of current issues. Broadcast live on the Newfoundland Sanctuary Church website, YouTube channel. Also, we thank you all for your wonderful potluck dishes. Let's give everyone a big round of applause who brought potluck today. Thank you all. And for the kids respecting the adults at lunch on Sunday, letting them go first, letting the adults go first. All are welcome, of course. Please do not take food into the small chapel or library. If you bring a dessert, please make it a healthy one. If you couldn't bring food, a $5 to $10 donation to cover the purchase of additional food will be appreciated. And let's give it up for our food ministry team, everybody. Food ministry team. Thank you, everybody. Also, join our Daughters of Christ Bakery Bake Sale. Support the Sanctuary Homeschool students. Raise money for a special trip to Thailand, Cambodia. That will be held during potluck lunch. Okay. All right, kids, it's Sunday school time. Let's thank all our Sunday school teachers, everybody. Thank you, Sunday school teachers. Kids, you can go to Sunday school teachers. Keep an eye on children, okay? And go ahead to Sunday school. Also, we have the first Chunyago King Cup shooting tournament. The shooting tournament winner, do we have a? Okay, is David Takahashi. He won the marksmanship award. There you go, David. Congratulations. Okay, that's for you. That's for you, okay? There you go. Chunyago King Cup shooting and fishing tournament. There you go. But you won the shooting part, right? Okay. He won the shooting part. There we go. Let's go. Let's get it. Congratulations. Good job. And that's why the police militia sign has the AR-15s. The rod of iron, remember, in the kingdom, the kings of this world, the kingdoms of this world will be ruled over by the rod of iron. And the rod of iron is inherited also to the co-heirs with Christ, whom he places as judges over the kingdom. And that's why sovereignty and our right to bear arms is so critical. Even yesterday, we were talking when we took Mrs. Kang out on our Saturday lunch date that we have. She looks forward to all week long. And what we're talking about, even now in Korea, there are ministers now starting to stand up against Sharia law, starting to expose the reality of the Islamicization of the West, and of course in Korea as well. They're trying to bring in radicals from different areas as well, in the East as well. It's the same globalist plan, the same UN plan, the same Rothschild plan to implode and divide and conquer countries so they can come in and swoop in and take control. But if you think about it, you have 1.5 billion Muslims, and of course, not all of them are, quote, radical, but if you are a serious Muslim and you take the Quran seriously and you actually believe in the Prophet Muhammad, who was a jihadi, he was a jihadi, okay? He himself cut off 800 heads of the Jews after he said they betrayed him. So he was a jihadi. And so if you are actually serious about your religion, not just like a nominal Christian in America, right? They don't even read their Bible, right? But it's the same in Islam. Most Muslims don't even read their Quran. They're just going to the mosque, do their prayers. Sometimes they don't even do their prayers. Well, we're in Turkey, right? And a lot of people just don't even do their prayers. They're supposed to, but they don't. But if you're serious about it, and if you actually believe in it, and you take it seriously, well, then you have to adopt the law that was given, the behavior that was given by the Prophet Muhammad in their religion. And of course, you have to allow, Nosuk Samani was telling me about now a Korean minister who was in Iran doing 20 years of ministry there, was exposing the fact that they're prepping girls at 9 years old and having a little celebratory party. Say, yay, you're ready to get married, now you're 9 years old. Because Muhammad was married to Aisha when she was six, and he was, what was he, 50? Muhammad, 51. He was 51, marrying a six-year-old girl. And he started consummating that marriage at 9 years old, when she was 9 years old. But of course, before that, he was molesting her, etc. But it's not only that, okay? Women can be beaten to some submission. You saw David Wood's exposés on that, on the reality of how women are treated in Islam. You can beat your wife. It's completely legal. The Korean minister was giving an example of a Korean woman who just believed in the lies of the apologists. I said Islam and Christianity the same. So she ended up marrying this guy who was Muslim. And then one day he said, oh, you know, I have another wife in Saudi Arabia, wherever she is, you know. By the way, I have another wife, and she's, you know, when I go to the Middle East, I go visit her. Because Allah allows me to have four wives. And of course, they try to explain, well, you know, Abraham and, you know, all the biblical figures had multiple wives. And, you know, anyways, like this. But the reality of Sharia law and the apostate cult, which is radical Islam, particularly Saudi-backed Wahhabism, which, of course, kills you if you leave the religion, beats you into submission if you are a woman. Your husband can beat you with a rod, completely legal, can go to prostitute brothels as long as it's done as a legal marriage. So, yeah, you marry the girl for 30 minutes or an hour, have sex with her, toss her out, sign a divorce paper, and you're legally fine in Sharia law. Okay. Also, the reality of the honor killings, etc. And the women have to produce four male witnesses, even though they're raped. When they're raped, they have to produce four male witnesses. Four male witnesses. And then she was going on telling how the Korean minister was explaining that was one of the hadith with Aisha, and or one of the brides of Muhammad, was apparently raped by somebody, and then he had to rule on it, but he didn't want to divorce her, because if she's raped, he has to divorce her. He didn't want to divorce her. He said, okay, well, you know, produce four meals, four male witnesses. And of course, they couldn't. And they had, what did they have? Seven women witnesses that came forth. But since women are half of a man in the justice system there, it only came out to 3.5 people. So they were overruled, and of course, he didn't have to divorce her, and the rapist got away with rape. Okay? So this reality as well is of course, spreading as fanaticism, as the economies implode, as disgruntled youth are sucked into radicalism and Saudi-backed Wahhabism, which is tons of millions of dollars, millions and millions and millions of dollars of radical jihadi funding, okay? So you have this kind of force, and it's not only a religion, obviously we know that, it is a political ideology. It does not come with just, that's why Father called Muhammad, Mahomet, Ma is Magui Ma, which means demon or devil. And Christians curse Red Moon, all that. He was in the Middle East, in Turkey. I was with him in front of 400 Muslims saying the Prophet Muhammad Ma is a devil. You can hate my father all you want. He's got bigger cojones than all of you combined. Yeah. And so that was a reality, and of course, but you have the spreading of the jihadism. And of course, the radical left in the West is allying with them to bring them in, to use them as the mafia tool, use them as the divide and conquer strategy, use them as the radical pit bulls, you know, tool to attack any of their political dissidents, attack anybody who wants to go against them, attack anybody, literally violence and death. And that's, of course, why they want to disarm every single person in the Western world, and of course that means now America. You have to understand, even the normal Christian is so brainwashed by state Christianity, state-run Christianity, whether it's Catholic state Christianity, or whether it's Protestant state-run Christianity, which is also funded by the federal government with various programs, and then they become beholden to them. So it's a very small section of Christianity now that is able type, that is standing up against these kind of things and, of course, risking their, you know, 501c3 status, all that, and say, I don't care about that. We just have to stand up against this evil. But there's so much, you know, glitter about Christianity, Joel Osteen and these kind of big church, you know, mega church preachers who take in tons of federal funding. Of course, that's why they cannot criticize the archangel, because they're being paid by the archangel. Okay, or get funding from the archangel. The Catholic Church, even though normal Catholics are fantastic and wonderful people, it's so unfortunate that their organization is one of the most largest international pedophile and sex trafficking organizations in the world. This time, the deputy pope literally getting now sued by the Australian government for child trafficking. So, I'm sorry for being informed, but that's the reality. Okay? The reality is state-run Christianity is not real Christianity, is not real kingdom Christianity, which understands the gospel of the kingdom, understands sovereignty, and God blessed humanity, Adam and Eve, with the blessing of be fruitful, multiply, and have dominion over the earth. And that's why the rod of iron is so important. The rod of iron, think about it, in the kingdom of God, it is not a centralized governance. All the citizens are called to be part of the peace, police, people, militia. There's no centralized law enforcement, no centralized military. The people train at the local level. The people have sovereignty at the local level. The people have the rod of iron at the local level. So if you have the start of a spread of the ideologies, radical ideologies that seek to overthrow sovereignty, freedom, liberty, free will, etc. Well, then you have the peace, police, people, militia right there to vanquish them, as they're, of course, terrorist organizations. Okay. The only power that can stop the spread of radical Shariaism and radical jihadism and Saudi-backed Wahhabism is the Chaniguk Constitution. You cannot do it with the glitterbug preaching Christianity. Real sovereignty must be had, and there must be a true and honorable Christian, Christ-centered civilization that is also empowered from everybody who is living there. So it is so critical for us to understand what sovereignty really means. What kind of price Christ had to pay for that sovereignty. The blood, sweat, and tear he paid for that sovereignty. We take it for granted. But it is a tremendous price that he had to pay. So yes, the world may look at your crown and say, ha ha, ha, look at those weirdos with the little crowns and the little warmonger crowns. Ha, ha. But as your sovereignty and your identity in Christ solidifies and Christ is able to strengthen you, you will see that crown will start becoming more and more powerful. Not so your kids can be spoiled and your generations in the future can be spoiled and try to fight over your assets that you've accumulated and put into crowns and other real royal assets. No. So they may learn the tradition of protecting the lineage and protecting the civilization and being honorable people. Of course, young people always become socialists and commie if they don't do hard things. And that's why people-to-people militia is so important. Training is so important because it forces the young people to face reality. Face reality and become unlocked in their epigenetics so they are not bamboozled by brainwashers in college and in Hollywood, you name it, that are trying to steal their sovereignty and make them join a sick pedophile cult that is trying to literally disarm everybody so they can sit on top of everybody and have their selection of sexual meats. So these are the powerful and trying times that we are living in. And of course, the Chinese Constitution. That's why Father was so, wow. Was Father was powerful on, when I get up there, I have to just let Father speak. So sometimes, I just have to disappear and let Father speak. And he was very upset that still, people came before his altar with a slave mentality. Did not honor him with the crowns that he's prepared. Right? That's why we also sang the song, No Longer Slaves, right? We're no longer slaves. No longer slaves. What does it mean to be a child of God, the child of the King of Kings? What does that mean? Is that just some nice little Christian, phrase you say to make yourself feel good? And what does that mean? What kind of incredible cosmic ramifications does that have? Okay. And he came down so powerful, and it was so clear. We must throw away the slave mentality. The slave spirit, the spirit of slavery. That's why it's amazing that Japanese members now, they're taking pictures with the AR-15s and AK-47, whatever. That's the firearm, the rod of iron, symbolizing their sovereignty, even though they're not real. I mean, you can't get them in Japan, right? But they're going to the, what is it? They're buying not airsoft. They're just buying the ones that are, they look like AR-15, et cetera. But it's that symbology, right? They're not able to access that because it's a different civilization and it's totally archangelic, right? The people really are slaves in Asia. But the Japanese members and now more and more Korean members Current members, I think, do it less, but Japanese members almost every week with Erika Kaicho-san are strongly proclaiming their sovereignty, putting their pictures up with those, even if it's mock guns, but still, they're putting it with sovereignty. They're taking those pictures and putting them up. Ah. That's a powerful declaration against the Archangel. Powerful. Because they're saying, okay, we may not have these now, but we will one day. And you predators will not be able to perch on top of us at that time. Koreans have to do it, too. The Koreans are going to have to do that, too. And the more the Archangel mocks you and laughs at you and curses you, we don't let you into our cult. You have a gun. Look at you, you caveman. How dare you have that? Don't you know we're all disarmed, but all our bodyguards have 20 guns on them at any time? They're so pathetic. They're such pathetic liars. And that's the great thing about this age. All their lies and hypocrisy has been exposed. Play that clip again, guys. Play that clip. Play that clip again of the second king. Go ahead. Play that clip. Oh, my gosh. That was so good. I was like, when did I say all that? Then he edited it into a rap video. Dubstep. Oh, Lord mercy. But that's literally what we're standing against that. Go ahead, play that clip.
I'm back at the King's Report this Tuesday, August 22nd, 2017. Broadcasting live from the Chenning Group Palace. I'm your host, Hyung Sean Moon, the second king of Chenning Group. They're mentally ill. They're in a cult. They literally don't know what planet they're living on. They think they're fighting the Klingons or something. They're living in Star Trek rerun episodes, watching Star Wars on replay VHS videos, playing Eminem in the background, thinking they're badass. They say war is peace. They agree with our enemies. Peace through violence. War is peace. You are the antagonist. Stupid idiots. Talking about, I got an AK-47. And this is the hole where the clip goes in. It's ridiculous.
All right. Oh my gosh. That is so good. We got to put that up. Put that up on the webpage, okay, guys? Put that up. That's amazingly funny.
I got an egg.
Did you see this? You see this? It was covered in the news. It's this lunatic leftist Antifa guy, and he's saying, I'm Antifa militia. He goes, this is my first gun I bought. Look, it's an AK-47. And this is the thing where you do here and the thing here, you pull this thing. And I think, oh, how do I do that? Oh, okay. This kid is like, my gosh. Here's a little clip. And I guess it goes, oh, it's in backwards. Oh, let's put it in again. Okay. Oh, my gosh. And these fools want to start a war with hunters and fishermen and veterans. They're out to lunch. They are crazy. They're literally in a suicide cult. All right, I'm not going to think of that. I already have my immune system already down. I've been speaking way too much this week. 3 hour plus broadcast, and of course 10 hours on Thursday, and all that kind of stuff. I got to stop speaking so much and start ranting so much. Even though it's quite entertaining, I know, to watch, but and to make dubstep videos of. But that's the type of scenario, okay? And the only thing that can stop this type of radicalization, these radical ideologies that are allying together, is a physical kingdom. That's why God's kingdom is not spiritual. Jesus said to Christians, every day you better pray. Every day, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven, where God has all the authority. Where the angels tremble at his feet. Where the devils dare not challenge him. And that's what we're talking about. Because it has to be that way on earth too. The predators and the demons and the archangels should tremble at the inheritors of the kingdom of God. they should tremble. Not only the authority, the might, the goodness, but also the power. And that is why the kingdom gospel is not preached. Because so many churches are state-run, and they're colluding with the archangel. And they want to protect their 501c3 status. And they're protecting big pedophile networks like even what here in Pennsylvania with the Catholic Church Network, or even the Penn State. What was that guy? Sandusky. He was running into some kind of, you know, orphanage thing. That's why they're not teaching their people to have kingship mentality, have arms and have the rod of iron and have true kingship perspective. They're not be brainwashed by the society telling you paper is true assets. But just like he told the church in Philadelphia in the book of Revelation, let no man take thy crown. Christians in America, even, they think it's weird that we're all wearing crowns. Well, they're weird. They're not reading their Bible. Believers are to receive crowns of glory. Believers are to be the inheritors of the kingdom of God on earth. Co-heirs with Christ. Bible says that no man take your crown. You're supposed to have a crown. Represents sovereignty. It represents your connection to the King of Kings. So when you have even good, well-meaning Christians who are going and are brainwashed by state-run Christianity, archangelic Christianity, Constantinian Christianity, Catholic Roman Christianity, even though they're very nice people and good people, they're able type definitely. They're definitely on God's side. They're not on saint's side. But they still may laugh at you and curse you and say you're in a cult while you're wearing a crown. But people may be laughing now as your crowns are cheap $5 Walmart crowns or ones you made out of little wire or whatever. But they won't be laughing when they start becoming real gold, real jewels, and are representing an entire kingdom with arms, with the rod of iron, with true Christian ethics to serve and love and protect goodness and to vanquish evil. No, they'll be lining up to see how beautiful your crowns look and how they wish they can have a crown, even though they've been cursing you and laughing at you. And that's what's so sad. State-run Christianity become completely sucked up and eaten up by the secular relativist culture. No longer trailblazing. No longer pioneering the pathway to liberation from the archangel. That doesn't mean they're all evil, of course not. They're still on God's side, of course. And they're still on the able side. So we must not think they're enemies or something like that. But I'm saying, the mocking and the laughing at you and all that kind of stuff, don't let it get to you. We must wear our crowns with pride, and you must never give up your guns. That is your rod of iron. And you must never let go of the Chinese Constitution, which then preserves that sovereignty and freedom for the entire world for all generations to come. So, with that said, I want to invite some of our international leaders here. Let's invite Dr. Reverend Lee Sang-yeol or Reverend Lee to come and give a brief report about his time here for the last few days and, of course, also in Korea Sanctuary as well. Let's all welcome Reverend Lee.
안녕하십니까.
Hello, everyone. 네,
한국에서 온 이상열입니다.
My name is Sang Yeol Lee. I came from Korea. 예.
오늘 왕님 양해분을 모시고 이렇게 식구님들 앞에 한국 보고를 드리게 된 것을 하나님 아버지 앞에 감사를 드립니다.
I'm very grateful to God and our true Father that I have this honor to report to you, to the King and Queen and to all the members about the current status of the Korean Church.
네, 제 시간은 20분입니다. 그러니까 간단하게 끝내도록 그렇게 하겠습니다.
I've been given 20 minutes, so I'll go through it briefly.
포인트가 네, 그 한국은 아버님께서 남북 통일에 대한 내용을 아주 강조를 많이 하셔서 오늘 거기에 대한 말씀 한 구절을 훈독하겠습니다.
Father always emphasized the importance of uniting South Korea, so I want to read some of Father's words about that.
한반도에 대한 한반도에서 대한민국은 공산주의와 싸워서 이겨야 할 숙명적인 위치에 놓여 있습니다.
We are in a position where we need to fight defeat communism on the Korean Peninsula.
공산주의와 싸워 승리할 때 대한민국은 세계에 웅비할 것이요. 공산주의에 패할 때 대한민국은 자치도 없이 사라질 것입니다.
If we fight and are victorious over communism, the Republic of Korea will become a worldwide country. But if we lose, then it will disappear without a trace.
패망의 비참한 운명은 월남의 예가 잘 보여주고 있습니다.
The example of defeat is given by the tragic situation of South Vietnam.
북한은 악을 대표하고 대한민국은 선을 대표하고 있습니다.
North Korea represents evil and the Republic of Korea represents goodness.
북한은 악마가 지배하고 대한민국은 하나님이 같이하고 계시는 것입니다.
North Korea is ruled by the devil and God is with South Korea.
이리하여 한반도는 세계에서 선과 악이 가장 날카롭게 맞서고 있는 세계사적인 지역이 되고 있으며 이 지역에서 선이 악을 무찔러 승리할 때 세계의 모든 악은 망하게 되는 것입니다.
So the Korean Peninsula is where good and evil are very sharply, most sharply divided, and it's a historic location in that sense. And if evil is defeated on the Korean Peninsula, then it will be defeated throughout the world.
하나님은 전 섭리사를 두고 이와 같이 한국 국민과 전 세계 자유인이 합하여 전체적 승리를 거둘 것을 고대하고 계십니다.
So God wants very much that the Korea and the people of Korea and all the freedom-loving people of the world come together to create a great victory.
천성경 1898쪽의 말씀입니다.
That was on page 1898 of the Korean version of 천성경.
네, 한 구절 더 훈독.
One more quote from Father.
남북 통일을 이루게 되면 민주 세계와 공산 세계의 통일도 여기에서 벌어질 것입니다.
When North and South are united, also the unification of the democratic world and the communist world will be accomplished.
한국 문제를 염려할 때는 전 세계를 대표한 자리에 서서 60억 인류를 대표하고 30억 아시아인을 대표하고 민족의 앞날, 세계의 앞날을 내다보아야 합니다.
So we are, when we are concerned about the Korean situation, we must think very much actually about the situation of the entire world population and the population of Asia.
참 아버님 조국 광복 251쪽에 있는 말씀이었습니다.
Page 251 of a book of a father's quotes on North Korea.
다음은 어떻게 통일된 체제를 만드느냐 하는 문제를 생각하게 될 때 그것은 사상적인 면에 있어서 민주체제와 공산체제를 넘어설 수 있고 그걸 다 소화할 수 있는 다른 하나의 통일 사상이 있어야 된다는 것입니다.
When we think about how to create a system of unification, we have to have one unification thought that will be able to transcend everything.
예, 조국 하나님의 조국 강복 148쪽의 말씀인데 이 사상이 두익 사상이라고 아버님 말씀 주신
And
것입니다.
Father said that this is actually the headwing thought, duik thought or headwing thought.
그러기 때문에 종족적 메시아 선포를 하게 된 것입니다.
And that is why we had a declaration of a tribal messiahs.
남북 통일이 아무렇게나 벌어지는 것이 아닙니다.
And North and South unification will not just happen by itself.
이것을 엮어 가지고야 가능한 것입니다.
It is only possible when we knit all these things together.
그것이 가정적 기준과 종족적 기준에 연결됐으니 국가적 기준에 연결될 것이고 그러기 때문에 통일교회하고 하나 되어야 되는 것입니다.
So the family level standard and the tribal level standard have been connected. So this has to be connected down to the national standard. And then that is why they must unite with the Unification Church.
참 하나님 조국 강복 160쪽 말씀이 되겠습니다.
Page 160 in the book True God and the Restoration of the Homeland.
다음은 올 연초에 왕님께서 영시 집회를 마치시고 한국에 대한 말씀을 많이 주셨습니다.
At the On God's Day this year, the midnight service, after completing that service, the King spoke a great deal about Korea-U.S. relations.
거기에 가장 핵심 부분은 참 아버님을 모시고 한미일 동맹이 강화되어야 된다 하는 말씀이셨습니다.
He emphasized that relations between the alliance between Korea, U.S. and Japan must be strengthened, centering on Father.
그래서 그 이제 한국에 귀국해서 한미 동맹 강화 국민 운동 본부를 만들었습니다.
And so we returned to Korea. We created the national headquarters for the strengthening of the Korea-U.S. alliance.
왕님께서 말씀을 주신 내용 중에 트럼프 대통령은 3대 왕권을 기반으로 해서 세워졌다 하는 말씀을 주셨습니다.
The King told us that the Trump administration was created on the foundation of the three generation kingships.
트럼프 대통령께서 이제 취임하시고 나서 가장 먼저 그 미국의 주요 장관 부대통령을 한국에 보내주었었습니다.
After his inauguration, President Trump sent two important members of the government and his vice president to Korea.
아마 우리 식구님들도 아시겠지만 대통령이 취임을 하고 짧은 기간에 이렇게 가장 중요한 국방부 장관 국무장관, 부대통령을 보내준 예는 없었을 것입니다.
As you may know, there are not many examples where the president sends his important members of cabinet and his vice president to a country so quickly after the inauguration.
이때 왕님께서는 저에게 말씀을 주시기를 이 국방부 장관인 제티스가 방문할 때 나를 환영하는 마음으로 이 장관을 환영해라 하는 말씀을 주셨습니다.
The king told us to welcome James Mattis, the Secretary of Defense, in the way that we would otherwise be welcoming the king.
그 이후에 왕님께서 최근에 계속 말씀 주시는 말씀 중에 미크로코스모스와 마크로코스모스에 대한 말씀을 많이 주고 계십니다.
And the king talks a great deal recently about the relationship between the microcosm and the macrocosm.
그 올 1월 달부터 우리 한국에서는 그 대통령을 이제 탄핵하는 문제가 진행되고 있었습니다.
In January, from January this year, the big issue was in South Korea was the impeachment of the president.
그때 이제 보수층 국민들이 태극기를 들고 나와서 대통령을 탄핵하면 안 된다. 탄핵을 막아야 된다 하는 그런 활동이 이루어지고 있었습니다.
The conservatives in Korea were coming out every week to have demonstrations opposing and trying to block the impeachment.
그때 왕님께서는 이 태극기 그러니까 보수층 국민들에게 한미 동맹을 강화시킬 수 있는 방향을 제시해 줘야 된다 하는 말이었습니다.
The king told us that we need to tell the conservatives to be focusing on strengthening the Korea-U.S. alliance.
그때 이제 우리 그 생초리 식구들은 그 이제 태극기를 든 그 국민들 앞에 미국 성조기를 들 수 있도록 저희들이 이제 노력을 하기 시작했습니다.
So we went to these demonstrations and we made an effort to also introduce the U.S. flag in there as well as the Korean flag that they were holding.
그래서 그 태극기를 든 그 국민들한테 이제 성조기를 몇 천 개를 준비를 해가지고 나눠주기 시작을 했습니다.
So we prepared thousands of U.S. flags and started handing them out to the people who were demonstrating there.
여기에 이제 보시게 되면 태극기와 이제 성조기 나가서 천일 국기를 들고 그 국민들에게 활동을 함께 시작하기 시작했습니다.
As you see here, we had people holding the U.S. and Korea flags as well as the 천일국 flag.
그리고 이제 이 아시아 지역에는 특히 중국이 원 아시아를 만들려고 하는 그런 전략을 가지고 있습니다.
Also, China right now is trying to create one Asia.
여기에 왕님께서 주신 말씀대로 한미 동맹이 깨지면 한국 속국 되는 것은 시간 문제다 하는 것을 이제 저희가 프랑카드를 들고 앞장서서 나가기 시작했습니다.
So we emphasize that if the U.S. alliance breaks, then it'll be just a matter of time before Korea becomes a vassal country of China.
이때 이제 그 이 탄핵을 방지하겠다고 하는 그 주최 측에서는 인원이 시민들이 500만이 몰려 나와서 이제 이 행사 그러니까 탄핵을 하면 되지 않는다 하는 그런 그 집회를 하고 있었습니다.
This was a demonstration opposing the impeachment, and the organizers claimed that 5 million people attended.
이때 이제 저희들도 여기에 그 요 정도의 이제 시청이 있습니다. 서울 시청.
The Seoul City Hall is over here.
이 시청에서 이제 시청 앞에서 행사를 마치면 이렇게 을지로 쪽에서 돌아서 행동 뒤로 해서 남단문을 해서 이 시가 행진을 늘 했었습니다.
So always in these demonstrations they would, after this rally, they would have a march through the streets of Seoul going from the foreground in this photograph up to that gate that you see in the background and then making a right turn over towards the Namdaemun direction. That would be the normal course for the march.
그런데 이제 저희가 이 남대문 쪽에 그러니까 평소 같으면 홈입니다. 뒤쪽에. 뒤쪽에 이제 저희들이 준비를 하고 있었는데 이렇게 500만이 나왔다고 하는 그날에는 이 본부 측에서 반대로 돌기 시작을 했습니다.
But we were actually preparing, we were, all of us were on the sort of the lower left hand of this photograph. In other words, we were at the very end of that. If they had marched in the regular way, that we would have been at the very end of the march, because that was where we were. But on that day, though, the organizers said, we have too many people to march in that direction, let's turn them all around and march in the opposite direction.
네, 그래서 이제 그 반대로 돌면서 예, 언론에서도 이제 하고 이것이 해외로도 나가는 이제 그런 그 일이 예, 있게 되었었습니다.
And so these photographs were also taken by foreign correspondents and reported around the world.
저희들이 이때 느낀 것은 예, 그 생초리 식구들은 많지 않았습니다. 인원도 많지 않고 또 그때 저희들이 가지고 있는 역량은 적었지만 이것은 아버님께서 이대 왕님을 통해서 저희께 주신 그 말씀을 저희가 실천해서 일어난 결과라고 예, 저는 그때 깊이 느끼게 되었습니다.
So we were not many, we were not large in size at all, but because of the reversal of direction, we suddenly were standing in the front of the march. I think it was because we united with the king's words that Father was able to do his spiritual work to place us in that leading position in that march through the streets of Seoul.
Yeah. 이제 한미동맹 강화 국민 운동 본부를 정식으로 출범을 시켰습니다.
And then following that, we had the official foundation inauguration of the ROC US Alliance and National Movement.
그리고 이제 그 유튜브 방송을 이제 개국을 해 앞으로 그 이 방송국을 중심하고 애국 운동을 강화시켜 나갈 것입니다.
And we've now started broadcasting on YouTube, and we intend to continue this effort to strengthen U.S. Korea alliance.
저 내용은 제가 그 미국에 오기 전 하루 앞날 지금 개국을 하고 이렇게 미국으로 왔습니다.
This photograph was actually taken the day before I left Korea to come here to the U.S. and we'll be continuing this when I return.
예, 왕님께서 이제 저희들에게 그 한미 동맹 강화에 대한 말씀을 주시면서 예, 이것이 통방격파 그러니까 아버님 계실 때 통방격파를 했던 그런 것처럼 예, 지금 시군구 읍면동까지 애국 조직을 만들어서 활동을 해 나가야 된다 말씀을 주셨습니다.
King has told us that we need to do this work in the same way that we were doing Tongbang Kyokpa, is breaking through the neighborhood level when Father was on the earth, to make, in other words, branches of this organization in each administrative level, right down to the village levels.
그래서 앞으로 그 한미동맹 강화 운동 본부는 전국 조직으로 그렇게 확산시켜 나갈 수 있도록 해 나가겠습니다.
So we will build this organization into a nationwide organization.
다음은 이제 올 들어와서 중요한 이제 성전을 이제 모든 것이 기반을 다 잃어버렸지 않습니까? 그러니까 이제 저희들 시작을 해야 됩니다. 그런데 지금 한국의 성전이 세워진 것은 정확하게 말씀드리면 2년 5개월뿐이 안 되었습니다.
As you know, our Father's foundation in Korea was all lost. Every bit of it was lost, and so we are starting again. And it's only been 2.5 years or so since the World Peace Unification Sanctuary was created in Korea.
이 인천 지역은 아버님께서 만물복귀 해양섭리의 출발지가 이게 인천입니다.
Father's Incheon is the place where Father began his effort for restoring all things, and especially the oceanic providence.
그래서 올해 인천에서 2월 24일 날 성전이 이제 출발을
On February 24th of this year, a sanctuary was created in Incheon.
그리고 구리는 장성 성지가 있는 곳입니다.
And Kuri is the place where is the growth level holy ground.
그런데 그 장성 성지 완전히 다 이제 허물고 거기에다가 지금 아파트를 짓기 위해서 성지를 싹 없애버렸습니다.
But now, of course, they have completely obliterated that holy ground, and it has been completely leveled now in preparation to build a apartment blocks.
여기에 지금 전상철 회장님하고 구리 성전에서 오신 식구님들 한번 좀 일어나
봐주시겠습니까?
네, 우리 저 전상철 회장님께서
전상철
네, 구리 성전에 이제 종매님으로 서시고 여기에 장로님들께서 장로님과 권사님들께서 뒷받침을 해서 지금 어느 지역보다도 활발하게 예, 성전 활동이 이루어지고 있습니다. 다시 한번 좀 박수 쳐 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
Mr. Chung is the head of that sanctuary, and they more actively than any other place in the country.
예, 그리고 이제 여수는 잘 아시겠지만 예, 아버님께서 예, 세계적인 모든 그 섭리에 예, 그 어떻게 보면 마지막 결실을 맺은 곳이 여수 지역이라고 볼 수 있습니다.
My father said that the Yosu is the place where the final fruit of the providence would be born.
예, 해양 천정궁을 세우시고 아버님께서는 이 천정궁을 해외에 계시다가 한국에 귀국하셔서 천정궁을 가시는 것보다는 여수 그리고 예, 해양 천정궁인 금운도를 아버님은 더 많이 예, 활용을 하셨습니다.
My father built the Oceanic Chonjogung Palace there, and he preferred that to the palace in Chongpyeong.
여기에 예, 그 여수 화양 성전이 3월 19일 날 이제 그 성전 봉헌식을 가졌습니다.
And on March 19th, we dedicated a sanctuary in the Huayang section of Yosu.
다음은 왕관 섭리에 대해서 말씀을 드립니다.
I will speak now about the Crown Providence.
예, 왕님께서 이제 올 1월 1일 예, 천일궁 입궁식 이후에 예, 왕관 섭리에 대해서 말씀을 주셔서 예, 시작을 이제 여기에 김가병 백선정 훈사님이 별도로 있어가지고 사진이 안 나와서 뒤에 계신데 미안하게 생각합니다.
Here on the March on January 1st, the King spoke about the Crown Providence, and here we are doing that in Korea. I'm sorry that Reverend Kim Gabyeong is not in this photograph, in a separate photograph. 네. He is here today.
네, 그리고 이제 처음에는 예, 예, 이렇게 지금
그
이 처음에는 이제 총을 들지를 안 했는데 지난번에 만물의 날 총을 들었기 때문에 그 이후에 이제 지금 왕관 즉위식을 하시는 분은 예, 평화군 평화 경찰이 되어서 함께 출발하는 예, 그런 모습을 볼 수 있습니다.
In the beginning, we were taking these photographs without the guns, but after the day of true all things. We started taking photographs with the guns. So people who do the crowning after that are holding the guns.
예, 그런데 지금도 계속 진행되고 있습니다.
And it's still continuing.
여기는 이제 야마구치 성전에서
야마구치 sanctuary.
네. 다음은 본체론 부분을 말씀을 드리겠습니다.
And then OSTP education.
이 본체론 부분은 예, 아버님께서 성화하시기 전에 마지막 교육을 시키시고 그 본체론 교육을 받은 분들에게 아버님께서는 신종족적 메시아라고 축복해 주셨습니다.
Father instructed this education early near the end of when he before he left the earth, and he for people who received. Education. He gave them the title of divine tribal messiahs.
그런데 이 본체론 를 강의했던 유정호 회장을 한 시어머니께서는 아버님 성화 이후에 모든 곳에서 이 본체론을 일체 강의하지 못하게 만들었습니다.
But the Han mother made it so that Reverend Yu, who had been instructed by her father to give this education, could not do that in any location.
예, 그래서 서울 성전 본부에서 이제 시작을 해서 이 부분은 창원 성전에서 이루어진 지방에서 이루어진 그 본체론 교육이 되겠습니다.
So we invited him to give this education first in the Seoul sanctuary, and now you see a photograph when he gave it in the Changwon sanctuary.
그리고 이제 지난 7월 8일에서 15일까지 여기 서울 본부에서 이제 시작이 됨으로써 전 세계적으로 그 다시 이제 본체론 교육이 시작되었다고 하는 것은 그 참 아버님께 감사를 드리지 않을 수가 없습니다. 특히 왕님 앞에 감사를 드립니다.
Of course, he gave the education also July 8th to 15th at the Sanctuary Church here in Newfoundland, and that will be the beginning of his going around the world again. I'm very grateful to the King for making this possible. Thank you very much.
이 성지 순례 부분은 우리 한국 식구님들께서는 가장 그 심정 속에 크게 자리 잡고 있다. 저는 그렇게 생각하고 있습니다.
Now this is the tour of the holy grounds, which is really the most important thing for the Korean members. You
know. 1월 달에 저희가 이제 1월하고 만물의 날까지 하면 약 80여 명의 식구님들이 이 생초리를 다녀갔습니다.
Between January and the and the day of our True All Things, about 80 members of our church have Korean sanctuary churches have come to the holy ground here.
이번 9월 달에는 아마 거의 100명 정도 식구들이 다녀갈 걸로 생각하고 있습니다.
I think that during the month of September, about 100 members will be coming to Newfoundland and to the Northeast Pennsylvania area.
이곳을 방문하는 것은 경제력이 풍부해서 오는 거 아닙니다.
It's not that people are rich that they come here.
아버님을 그리워하고.
They miss father.
왕님 양해분과 참 가인님 네 분이 이곳에서 아버님을 모시고 그 종적인 기준을 세우신 그것을 상속받고 그 심정을 공유하고자 하는 그런 심정으로 이곳을 찾아옵니다.
They're coming because they miss father and because they know that the king and queen and also the true Cain's couple are here. They have established that vertical foundation here and they want to come and inherit that.
다음은 축복 부분을
And then about the blessings.
아버님께서는 늘 저희들에게 교차 축복을 해야 된다. 그래서 세계를 하나로 만들어야 된다 하는 말씀을 많이 주셨습니다.
Father often spoke about how we have to have international and interracial exchange blessings.
이 가정은 지금 우크라이나와 한국 가정이
This couple, the husband is Korean and the bride is Ukrainian.
여기는 미국하고 한국 가정.
And this is Korea and people.
여기는 한한 가정이.
This is a Korean and Korean couple.
여기도 한한 가정.
And another Korean and Korean couple.
여기는 이제 한국에는 기본적으로 총을 가지고 개인이 보유할 수 그러니까 집에 보유할 수 없습니다.
In Korea, fundamentally, people cannot own guns and keep those guns in their homes.
그런데 이제 왕님께서 총기 소유 그리고 이 소유권을 지키기 위해서는 반드시 총기 소유를 해야 된다 하는 말씀을 주신 이후에 이 이제 서울 이 생츄리 식구들이 그 서울에는 이제 이 서울이 아니고 한국에서는 이 수료 파는 사람들은 그 일정한 기간에는 총기를 활용할 수가 있습니다.
The king has emphasized the importance of owning guns for sovereignty, and so we're doing the best we can in Korea. And then there is a certain time of year during the hunting season, people, hunters are allowed to have their guns.
여기에는 이제 수료 면허증을 따기 위해서, 그러니까 수렵을 하기 위해서는 그 면허증이 필요한데 그것을 따기 위한 이제 과정의 한 부분으로 총을 그러니까 사격하는 사격장의 모습입니다.
And to be a hunter, you have to have that license. And so here you see this is part of the process of getting a hunter's license to go to a shooting range and practice shooting, learning how to shoot in this way.
왕님께서 말씀을 주시면 그 아주 저 작은 단계이지만 시작은 바로 합니다.
Once the king gives us instruction, we try our best to begin even in a small way like this to realize what he says.
그리고 이제 왕님께서 천일국 헌법에 대해서 강조를 지금 많이 하고 계십니다.
And the king is also emphasizing much about the constitution of the 천일국.
네, 요것은 지금 한국에서 제작을 하고 요런 사이즈 또 그리고 홍보용 리플렛 또 만들어서 지금 홍보에 그 활용하고 있습니다.
This is what we've publications that we've created in Korea. That size, and also we created a leaflet for outreach.
왕님께서 그 설교 시간에 한국의 정규제라는 이름을 가끔 말씀하십니다.
The king sometimes mentions 정규제 in his sermons.
이분이 정규제 주필이 되겠습니다.
This is this man here, former editor-in-chief of the Korean Economic Daily.
이거는 헌법을 전달하는 그런 그 모습입니다.
We are giving him a copy of the Constitution here.
다음은 이제 성화 청년들 활동에 잠깐 사진 보시고 제 오늘 보고는 마치도록 하겠습니다.
I'll conclude just by showing some photographs of our youth activities.
이제 주짓수 배우기 위해서
learning
주짓수 지금 활동을 하고 있습니다. 여기는 그 정윤이라고 청년이 지난번에 여기 와서 좀 있다 갔죠. 그리고 어머니하고 지금 이렇게 하고 있습니다.
This is a son and his mother. This is a Chung Yun who was here for a while and learned some things here. So he went back and he's doing it with his mother.
네, 이렇게 우리 청년들이 청년들이 지금 유튜브 방송을 오픈했습니다.
And we have, this is our YouTube channel, the Tomuni TV.
네, 토무니 TV입니다. 무니 TV입니다. 무니.
Well, it's, in other words, the Muni television, Muni TV.
네, 요는 저 우리 성화 학생들이 이번에 수련 갔던 그런
겁니다. Summer camp.
네, 감사합니다. 이상 보고 마치겠습니다.
Okay, next lesson, Mrs. Erikawa Kaicho.
Minasan, konnichiwa.
Hello, everyone.
Nihon Sanctuary Kyokai. Watashi ga houkoku suru no wa Nihon no subete dewa arimasen. Prince Alpha ga aru to omotte kudasai. Betsu no grupu mo arimasu node. Soshite kyou watashi wa Mariko san ga この場でちゃんとつけなければいけないとプレゼントしてくれた10ドルのこれつけましてそれからここにはクッチン人 の売店に行った時に買いました銃がついています 全くシンボルですけれども、私はいつも絶えずサタンと見えないサタンと戦っている本物の平和軍、平和警察です。どうぞこれから報告をしたいと思います。
I'll be repeating これ逐次通訳ですのでちょっと間隔を置いてくださいね。はい。I'll be reporting on my group's, my organization's activities in Japan, but please understand that there are other organizations, so that there is more than what I'm reporting here. And I'd like to thank Mariko for lending me her $10 crown. She said I must wear this. And also I have this pin that I bought at Cook Janim's store. And so that this shows that even all these are just a symbolic, but I am a true peace militia member.
2017年天一宮入宮から鎮士族召使や王権即位式までの日本サンクチャリ教会の主な活動を報告します。
I'll be reporting from the January 1st entry into the Chonyugung Palace up to the crowning ceremonies of the divine tribal messiahs.
日本を出てくる9月5日の直前までこれ作っておりまして、十分ではありませんのでよろしくお願いします。
We were creating this report right up until the time that I left Japan on the 5th, so I'm afraid that it may not be as complete as I like.
昨年アメリカトランプ大統領が当選しまして、マクロの天柱的あるいは世界的中心人物と、そしてそれを守るためのミクロの王様がまず、アメリカトランプ大統領の就任の前に天一宮に入宮しなければならないということで入宮されて、この2007年は本当に新しい次元の設立が始まったと自覚しております。
2017 was the beginning of a completely new providence because Donald Trump was elected president last year, and then also the king and queen entered the Chonyugung Palace the beginning of this year, so that the macro and micro were connected in that way.
そしてキングスレポートも始まりました。そして大きなその設立の転換は何であったかと言いますと、私たちにとりまして天暦の1月1日神の日でしたけれども、その神からの御言葉、天来の御言葉をいただきました。
We received a word from the king on the 1st of January of the heavenly calendar.
まあ簡潔に言いますと、藩士重荷の堕落によって韓国は天運が 95% 去って 5% 再起の可能性があるけれども、下院革命が進んで亡国の危機であると。
One was that by the failure of the Han mother, by her fall, Korea has lost 95% of its heavenly fortune. There's 5% possibility that it can recover, but there is a Cain type of revolution going on, and then there areCrisis that could lead to the destruction of Korea.
それで日本は 50%、50% でマクロの代表であるトランプ政権とつなぐことによって生き残る道があるという御言葉をいただきました。
And Japan though has a 50-50 chance, and Japan can survive if they're able to connect with the administration on the macro level.
それで私たちは早速2月3日にはマティス国防長官が来日をしまして歓迎をいたしました。
So when Defense Secretary Mattis visited Japan on February 3rd, we welcomed him.
一番左にある人は安藤さんというんですが、この救国運動を先頭に立ってしたんですが、聖話をしました。でも本当にこの運動をすることによって本人は満足であったと思います。
Mr. Ando that you see on the left there has since passed into spirit, but I think he was very satisfied that he was able to do this work before he left the earth.
そして2月11日には日、どの国よりも最初に、トランプ大統領と日本の安倍首相との日米首脳会談がありまして、それを勝利するように私たち活動しました。
On February 11th, Prime Minister Abe was the first foreign leader to have a summit conference with President Trump, and we had an event to mark that victory.
それで、まず2017年の始動、私たちは具体的にはこの神の日の間に帰りまして、 全国124の救命ボートの代表が私たちのセミナーハウスに集まりまして、2017年をどう活動していくかということを会議しました。
We gathered at our workshop center and we had a workshop to discuss how we're going to, what we're going to do during this year.
で、最初に、まずはずっと継続してきたことですけれども、お父様の権威のもとに戻る祝福を、期待を作って、そして王様を作らなければいけないということで、2016年2月13日までは世界で2100艘ですが、日本は約1200家庭をさせていただきました。
2100 couples are returned to True Father's authority by February 13, 2016.
そして次に王様が次は4300艘だということでしたので、私たちはいつも日本は半分以上しなければいけないということで実施申告をいたしまして、今200艘を目標にしております。
And after that, the king gave us a direction worldwide to 4,300 couples. And so our goal is 2,200. ちょっと訂正してよろしいでしょうか。2,100 艘というのは2月13日、その日に戻った人であり、それ以前にも、2015年にも、またありますので、全体で3,000 艘です。So actually, I want to make a correction here that 2,100 was the number that returned on February 13th, but there was another blessing in 2015 where we had more. And so the total number of couples who returned to Father's authority by his birthday, 2016, was 3,000 couples, not 2,100.
さすが本部長です。ありがとうございます。
That's an important number. So
今翻訳しませんでした。それで2016年の神の日までには日本では747艘をしました。
And so by God's day in Japan we did 747 couples.
そして、その後今まで78艘、昨日はやってるんですけれども、2200を目指しています。
And so our goal this year was 2,200, and by God's day we did 747, and then 78 after January 30, so a total of 825. Our goal for the year is 2,200, but anyway, we are doing our best constantly towards that goal.
9月の10日ですね、こちらで9月7日の祝福のサテライトを東京と大阪でしておりますので、多分今報告が来ているのは10艘は間違い、片方は来ているし、全国的に報告がまだ間に合わないんですが、840ぐらいになっているはずです。
And we are doing the satellite blessings of the blessing that was performed here on the 7th, two locations in Japan, and we haven't received a complete report of that, but I expect that the total will be about 840 when we get those reports.
一日も早く全世界で4300艘を勝利して、王様のしっかりした基盤を築かなければいけないという責任感を持っており、使命感を持っております。
We have a very strong sense of responsibility and sense of mission that we need to accomplish this 4,300 couple blessings throughout the world as quickly as possible, and Japan will do its best to help that accomplishment.
それから、マッチングの祝福ですね、あるいは寄生家庭の祝福ですが、2016年までは41艘でした。今年はまだ12艘。しかし、今回8艘してますから20艘です。これから追い上げていきます。
And these are the blessings that have been performed in 2016. These types of blessings at second generation, first generation, spirit world and so forth. 41 couples last year and then 12 couples this year. But then we're going to really be working hard to speed this up.
そしてですね、私たちは特に2世、3世、やはり、私たちの代がいくら頑張っても、2世、3世が2代王、3代王の私たち以上の人物になって、お支え申し上げなければいけませんので、そこに力を入れております。
And we're putting a lot of effort into second generation and third generation education because no matter how much we work, we have to have younger people who will support the second king and the third king.
それで昨年の12月31日年末から1月4日冬休みですので全国の中高生希望者を集めて特に原理公論の訓読をみんなチームに送って監読して大きな成果を上げその後子どもたちは自分で訓読をするようになっています。
So at the year end and beginning during the winter vacation in Japan, we had a young people's workshop with 32 people participated and they read through the entire divine principle. They divided into teams and they all read through it.
これは青年たちのその後全国の中高生セミナーをやりました。
Here the middle and high school student events that we've had after that.
それから春のゴールデンウィークの時には青年のセミナー、これは全国版の話だけをしています。
Spring vacation, 34 people at a young adults seminar. These are only national events that I'm reporting here.
そして私たちには群馬セミナーハウスがありますが、セミナーハウスとそれからファームがあります。そこで子どもたちに土をいじり、そして土を作り、種を植え。苗を植えるそういう訓練をしております。
We have a farm, a couple of farms in Japan, and here one of those farms you see our young people learning how to plant things, seeds and seedlings.
そしてキャンプファイヤーでの証し会、あるいは和道会。
Witnessing and witnessing session around a campfire. Fellowship.
それから8月夏休みはお父様が小学校5年生からですから。11歳ぐらいですかね。11歳ぐらいから絶対性の教育をしなければいけないという御言葉がありましたので、今年は小中高ちょっと年齢幅が広いんですけれども、その一緒にセミナーをしました。
And we had an absolute sex seminar. Father said that sex education should begin at 11 years old, fifth grade. So we gathered people in the during the summer month. And 22 people participated. It was a wide range because we had elementary, middle, and high school students there.
テーマは、絶対性でした。
And absolute sex was the theme of that event.
で、隣のは、花火です。原子爆弾ではありません。
And then the one next to it is not an atomic bomb. That's a fireworks.
そして子どもたちもこのように、畑、ファームで草取りをし、それから池で魚を捕み取りをしたり、自然の中で訓練をします。
Grabbing a fish in a pond where the water's been let, and also working on the dirt there you see on the right.
これは班に分かれて子どもたちが催し物ですけれども、
and here this is the entertainment time where the team by team.
人形劇をやったり。機械体操をやったり、
very gymnastics,
まあ子どもたちで自主的にそれぞれ発表して、日本人は非常にシャイですから、これをもっと押し出しの効く青年に作りたいと思っております。
Japanese are very shy, so we want to create, educate our young people to be less shy, not as shy as they are.
そして青年も一緒に。この旧国、旧アジア運動に出かけて演説を始めている青年もおります。
Some of our young people are also working with us on the Save the Nation, Save Asia effort.
これは全国各地で北海道ですね。
This is in Hokkaido.
それから東京、これはもう畑を、草を取ったり、夏は大変です。
Tokyo area, weeding, pulling out all those weeds.
そしてこれは名古屋ですが、
And this is in Nagoya.
原理講義。絶対性のセミナー
and absolute sex education seminar. 名古屋
これは中部で
central Japan.
岐阜三重ですね
岐阜 and 三重 prefectures.
そのところでやっているところですそして中のこういう資格を取って
received her license
子供たちが現れています to
a gun to be a hunter
それから訪米セミナーですが、
5
月の1日から8月の20日、ブルーストーンファームにおいてインターンシップに参加した者が第1次が4名、現在第2次が2名参加させていただいて、本 青年が生まれ変わっている、まあ、その辺にいるはずですけれども、
本当に青年が
生まれ変わっています。ありがとうございます。
Four interns at the Bluestone Farm and then two now are Bluestone Farm.
はい、これはブルーストーンファームのですね。
Their internships there.
はい。
They're really being, and I'm really grateful for Bluestone Farm for their effort there.
アメリカの先ほどビデオがありましたが、13日から20日までファミリーキャンプに14名が参加させていただきました。アメリカに来て皆さんの協力を得て、日本人だけが教育を受けるよりもインターネットで一緒にやるのが大きな成果が上がるというのをはっきりと分かりました。来年はよろしく皆さん ご協力をお願いします。
What we discovered is that rather than having Japanese come here and being educated just among Japanese, it's much more effective if they're educated with people of other countries. So we will be doing this again next year.
多くの者たちがそのアメリカと日本の文化の違いを如実に感じるわけですね。
Our people can really understand clearly the difference in culture between Japan and the United States.
自分の意見を堂々と言えるものにならないといけないという刺激を受けてきました。
And they were very strongly encouraged to be able to state their own opinions.
例えば代表こういう報告がありました。代表祈祷する人と言ったら、はいはいはいとアメリカでは3歳の女の子まで手を挙げると。自分たちはスーッと引いてしまう。
One person said that during the summer camp, when volunteers were requested to give a prayer, many, many people were holding up their hands. Even a three-year-old girl was holding up her hand. But the Japanese would sort of slide into the background.
それからある青年はですね、これ今まで自分のその人生の中心がなかった、漠然としていた。これからは神様とお父様と、そして二大王、三大王権と、そして御言葉を中心でなければいけない。ということを固く決心して帰ってきた兄弟もおります。
Another person said, until now there was no central, nothing in the center of my life, no central pillar in my life. But from now on, God and true Father, the second King and the three generation kingships will be the second, will be the central of my life.
今年のですね、今年の枠は14名ということでなったんですが、ぜひその数を増やしてほしいという親や青年自身の希望でございますので、来年はくれぐれもよろしくお願いします。
This year we limited to 15 people from Japan in the summer camp, but we have a lot of pressure right now from parents and from young people themselves to increase that number. So I hope that you'll be able to take care of us next year.
これはそのアメリカのですね。
This is our people.
そしてキャンプから残して日本サンクチャリーで協力。レイクサンクチャリーに泊まり、また抵抗して HQ を訪問して非常に喜んで帰ってきました。
They stayed at the Lake Sanctuary and also they did some shooting. They visited the Chunigung Palace and they had a lot of very good experiences.
それから組織的なことですけれども、救命ボートということで124箇所でストップしておりました。しかしこれからこの運営をどうするかということを考えておりましたのでストップしておりましたが、最近もう少し救命ボートを増やそうということで最近134箇所になっております。
We had stopped the growth of our lifeboats at 224 because we weren't sure how to manage that kind of organization, but now we're increasing it a little by little. Now we're up to 134 now.
それで首都圏は毎週月曜日9時から2、3時間になりますが、ズーム会議をしております。
And in the capital area, Tokyo area, we have a Zoom conference every Monday from 9 o'clock in the evening.
そして火曜日は地方ズーム会議。だいたい地方の時には50救命ボートが参加します。
And then on Tuesday nights every week, we have a meeting for lifeboats outside the Tokyo area. Usually have a 50 plus lifeboats participating there.
そして、王様の御言葉、それから大陸会長会議での内容等々を迅速に伝えるようにしています。
And through these meetings, we talk about the event of the Thursday international meeting and other instructions and words from the king.
それから教育を深めませんと、本当に家庭連合時代、日本は献金献金で教育がされていませんし、特に二世や三世は犠牲的にほとんど教育されていないという状況です。
During the Family Federation era, Japan focused almost exclusively on donations, and so very little effort was done for education. And so we are putting a lot more effort on education that's really necessary. Especially the second and third generation were really sacrificed in that sense. We had 16 one-day seminars for blessing candidates. 243 people total participated. This is only things that are not including things that are done on a local level, only on a national level. 79 second generation and 56 first generation participated.
もっとより深めなければいけないと思いまして、ワンデーは5回なんですけれども、より祝福に向かえるように、また深く教育が進むように、今、教材、御言葉の教材を作っているところです。
This year we are trying to deepen that education, so we've only done 5 this year, and we are preparing the Divine Principle education materials to do this.
そして大きく今年変えたのは、その会議でですね、134のその救命ボートを本部で主管するのではなくて、現場に下ろしながら、みんなが裾野を広く組織が広がるように体制した。
And one big organizational change this year is that we've divided the country into regions so that we are not trying to manage all 134 lifeboats from the headquarters, but rather we're putting pushing that down to the local level so that we can increase our base much more widely.
日本列島の地図ですが、上の方からですね、北海道、東北、 甲信越、北陸、関東、それから中部、東海、関西、中国、四国、九州と大きなブロックにしまして。
We've divided the country into 8 blocks, as you see here, in the colors.
そこに、みんなで中心者を決めなさいと。
And we did not appoint the central figures here. We told the people in those areas to appoint their own central figure.
特にですね、項目別にこの委員を
And we've created 5 committees around the country.
祝福委員会,
the Blessing Committee,
聖和委員会,
the Songhua Committee,
教育委員会,
the Education Committee,
青年委員会,
the Young Adults Committee,
旧国旧アジア委員会,
the Save the Country, Save Asia Committee.
その, 各ブロックごとに各委員が、そして委員が先頭になって一緒に活動ができる、スムーズに現場に裾野が広く組織化できるようにしました。
And different areas around Japan send have people in the on these committees so that we can work more effectively around the country.
これは祝福委員会ですけれども。
This is the Blessing Committee meeting that you see here.
祝福委員会は月に1回ですが、
They have a Zoom conference once a month on the fourth Friday.
そして一つ進めているんですが、最近ですね、始めましたのは子供の祝福を願う親の集いをやってました。
And recently we've created something called the Gathering of Parents Who Want Their Children to Be Blessed.
親マッチングが許されている時代ですので、親自体をしっかりとさせないと。 拡大していかないというのを分かりましたので、まず親が集まりました。8月12日に。 10家庭も集まればいいと思いましたら、実際28家庭43名が参加しました。
On our first meeting of this assembly on August 12th, we were thinking maybe if 10 couples come, 10 families from that'd be good, but actually 28 came to Tokyo, 43 people from 28 families attended. It's really necessary because of the parents are allowed to match their own children now, so we have to educate the parents.
で、 10月にはですね、名古屋でやる。
And in October, we're scheduled to do this again in Nagoya.
The 11月は大阪.
And Osaka will be in November.
12月は福岡と九州ですけれども。
And Fukuoka will be in December.
そして親たちも拡大し、そして子どもたちも拡大していくと。
So we're going to educate more parents and more children about the blessing.
それから聖和委員会を作りまして、本当に真心から年頃にこの。
So that we are able to send people off with very sincere way.
委員たちが集まって、まあ、何にもないところですから、委員たちが集まってですね。で、私たちがしたの16箇所やってきました。
And we've done 16 songha ceremonies so far.
今までです。みんな私に来て、私があっちにこっちにこの曲を取って、これではダメだと。そして聖話というのは突然起こりますので、各委員会でみんなが一緒に協力してやると。非常にスムーズに行えるようになりました。
Before we had this committee, then when someone would pass, then I would get the notice, and I would have to recruit people and everything, and I was having to do everything. We have this committee that can take care of this, so that everything can be done smoothly.
まあ、いろいろな規模のものですけれども、ですから、家庭連合からこのサンクチャリー教会に行ったら聖和式してもらえないんではないかと。こういう心配があった人たちの一切心配がなくなりました。
Previously, people were worried that if they joined the sanctuary church, they wouldn't be able to have a songha ceremony when they passed. But now, there's no reason to have that concern anymore.
それから他のことは割愛しまして、旧国旧アジア運動についてお話をしたいと思います。
I'll talk now about the work for Save the Nation, Save Asia.
これも旧国旧アジア委員会でするんですが、現在、まず We love Donald Trump ということで、ここに焦点を当てれば何でもいいということでですね、全国各地で活動を始めているのが今三十数箇所において好きな名前で、このとにかくトランプさんとつながればいいと、好きな名前でやりなさいということで、みんながそれぞれいろいろな名前でやっております。
So this is also one of our five committees, and we've told people as long as you connect with Donald Trump, do anything you want, you can create your organization with your own name. So people have created very creative names, and they're doing many things. We're about 33 locations around the country now where this is work, where this is going on.
毎週1回街頭に出てですね、やるところもあるし、1ヶ月の2回のところもあるし、1回のところもあるし、とにかくあちらこちらでこのような拠点を中心に救命ボートを中心に救国救世活動をしています。
So some places go out onto the street and do lecturing once a week, some places twice a month. Anyway, on 33 locations are based centering on lifeboats, so they're trying to do something to save the nation, save Asia.
最初はトランプ政権の歓迎と、トランプ政権の重鎮が日本を訪れたときに、どこに行ってもこの私たちが歓迎をしているという姿を見せなさいということでですね、おかげさまでうちのサンクチャリのメンバーはマチス国防長官、ティラーソン国務長官、そしてペンス副大統領とか、みんな名前みんな覚えてます。
We were told in the beginning when Mattis, Secretary Mattis visited that we should go and greet him every place he visited. So Mattis and Tillerson and Vice President Pence. Now all members know the names of these American officials who have joined, who have come to Japan.
国民の中にはですね、アメリカの大統領が誰だかも知らないような青年もたくさんいるわけです。
There are many young people in Japan who don't even know the name of the President of the United States.
私たちの老若男女みんな、大使はハガティアメリカ大使が来ているとか、みんなスムーズにしております。
But our people, even if they may be old, even if they're very old people, they know the name of the U.S. ambassador to Japan even.
まあこういうふうにしてですね、マチス国防長官、
So we greeted Mattis and
国会の前ですね。
In front of
それからアメリカ大使館の前、
Parliament and in front of the U.S. embassy.
これは日本の一番この。何ですか、政府の関係者が通るところでの示威活動。
Demonstration in Tokyo where there are a lot of government offices, government employees.
日米首脳会談を祈願し。
And our prayer for the Japan-U.S. Summit conference.
ティラソン国務長官来日。これはアメリカ大使館の前ですね。
This is in front of the U.S. embassy.
それからこれも各地でしまして。
And also around the country.
ティラソン国務長官が出かけていくところの情報を知って、
so,
そこに行きました
。We would find out where Rex Tillerson would be going, and we would get that information, then we would be there to greet him whenever he arrived.
正常期を振っている方は83歳のおばあさんです。
This woman on the right, she's an 83-year-old woman, with the American flag.
老若男女, どこにでも出かけて活動しております。
Old and young, men and women all go out to do this work.
で、東京ばかりでなくて地方でも。
And not just in Tokyo, but also around the country.
しました。
We did this.
はい。地方でも同じように、宮城、あるいは、宮城というのは仙台ですね。それから名古屋とか、
宮城 near Sendai and Osaka.
大阪、兵庫、徳島、福岡の小倉。
So different cities, different cities around the country.
そしてこれはペンス副大統領が来られたときに、この全国の各地で歓迎大会をしているわけです。
Around the country.
はい、こうして、みんな、これは大使館に向かってここに、5人以上来てはいけないと。
There was a rule that you cannot have a demonstration of.
前には行っていけないと。たくさんの規制があるんですけれども。
More than five people in front of the embassy, and you can't have to stay a certain distance. But anyway, we had this event there as close as we could.
これは名古屋ですね。
And in Nagoya.
これはアメリカ大使館。
And the U.S. embassy.
はい。そして。ついにですね、日本ではなかなか難しいんですが、ペンス大統領が、
副大統領が通る前で
中から手を振り、本当に喜んでいる姿を見ました。それから、アメリカの大使が、
ハガティ
大使が来日した時には、歓迎の準備をしました。それからつい先日ですね、自分はとにかく市会議員の選挙に出て、朝から晩まで、晩から朝まで、トランプ、トランプと言っていくということで、トランプ大統領の支援の祈りを持ちながら、選挙戦に出た兄弟もいます。それから安倍政権も応援をしています。
で、
都議会選が来た時には、安倍首相が、多くの中学校や高校学校の講堂に来られましたので、それを私たちは追いかけて、そして安倍総理を応援してますということで、非常に安倍総理と親しくなったような気がします。
Election in Tokyo for the Tokyo Prefectural Council. And he would go there and he would do electioneering, and so he would meet him here. He's doing a high five with one of our members on the left.
私たちの激励をすることになりました。こちらでこの安倍総理を書いたチラシなんですけれども、これを見てるのが安倍総理です。
And you see on the man on the right looking at one of our leaflets. That's Prime Minister Abe looking at one of our leaflets with his photograph on it.
それでアジアの自由を守る日韓会
と Japan Korea Association to protect freedom in Asia.
韓国の姉妹は韓国の実情を本当に憂えています。
The Korean sisters in Japan are really concerned about the situation on the Korean Peninsula.
別の組織を作りまして、デモ行進をしてきました。
And having demonstrations.
これは三一節の時ですね。
And this is March 1st.
東京新宿デモ行進をしました。
Day in Korea.
これは120万、5月8日、韓国の大統領選の前の日です。
This is the day before the presidential election in Korea.
なんとか神側が勝つようにという祈りを込めて、120
万、
日比谷公園からですね。
Demonstration, demonstrating in
高官庁のあるところです。
Tokyo. This is also in the area of Tokyo where there are a lot of government offices.
それから東京、この今度はこれは7月15日ですか。
This is July 15th.
日の丸と手首を掲げて、
demonstrating with the Korean and Japanese flags.
しましたね。それから、毎週じゃない、月に2回ですけれども、
twice a month.
韓国の韓国の大使館前とアメリカ大使館前、それから日本首相官邸前で続けています。
U.S. Embassy and the official residence of the Japanese Prime Minister. They have demonstrations.
で、これは全国各地で展開される内容です。北海道。
And this is around the country. Various locations around the country.
それからこれは宮城県ですね。
宮城 Prefecture, Tokyo.
これは首都圏、東京。
And this is also in Tokyo. And this is in
Kanagawa. これは神奈川、横浜があるところですね。
Where Yokohama is.
静岡、浜松。
And in Shizuoka.
それから愛知県ですね。豊川豊橋とかですね。
愛知
それで、 みんな毎日演説をしますので、
And everyone is street lecturing every day.
多くの弁士ができました。And so we've got, we've アジアの
have now a lot of good lecturers.
訴える弁士ができました。Because
they're practicing often like this on the street.
兵庫。
And this is in Hyogo Prefecture and Gifu Prefecture.
And 四国松山ですね。
City and 大分 Prefecture and Kyushu.
車も小さな車ですけど。
Car,
宣伝カーを作りました。
And we, an electioneering car.
これは福岡。
And this is in Fukuoka and in
これは鹿児島。これは熊本。熊本そして、チラシもですね、本部で作って配るなんていうことが家庭連合方式でしたけれども、それはしません。作ったのを発表して、あ、それが自分たちは使いたい。これどうぞとか言いながらいろいろなチラシを作っています。
それ
その能力もできました。
The headquarters would create the leaflets and then send them out to the areas around the country, but we don't do that. Instead, each locality creates its own leaflets and then shares that to people and says, "Oh, I want to use yours. I want to use that one." And so then they share that ones that are good.
まあこんな自主的にですねしています。
And this is how we were doing this on our own in that way.
それから新種族メシア王権即位式ですが、
お父さん
二代王に、そして二代王が私たちにくださいまして、
現
在ですね、日本では47都道府県ありますが、
we have 47 prefectures in Japan.
この後また増えてますので、35の都道府県で、
we have 35 prefectures now where these crowning ceremonies have been performed.
刀を持っている人もいます。
Some people have,
私たちは全員が全あの銃を持ちます。必ず銃を持ちます。
We always have, guns.
それで、ですね必ず銃を持っているんですが、現在、登録されているこういう銃を持って王冠をかぶって登録されているのが222です。
222 couples have taken photographs like this and registered with us. So we are increasing that, and we will continue to increase that.
それで、今年は三大王権とともに国創建に幕臣しましょうと。幕臣というのは音を立てて進むということです。
So, we are going now to, go forward with a loud noise, for the three kingships.
幕臣すると。
幕臣。幕臣 means to move forward with a loud noise.
神の国に向かって幕臣。
So, we are going to move forward to God's kingdom, with a loud noise.
Thank you, Mrs. Erikawa.Wow, did you see those shocking pictures in Japan? Who is this? What is this weird movement with all these crowns and all these AR-15s? Wow. Let's give it up one more time for Reverend Lee and Mr. Erikawa. Thank God for all their work they're doing all over. What? That's a weird movement that is spreading around the world.And what do they believe in? They believe in private property and non-federalization of the government and believe in, you know, citizens' arms and peace-believing militia. And, oh, look at this. No international bankers can come in and muck it up and the commies, or, commies can't take it over. Oh, that's interesting. It must be the kingdom of God. Well, of course, we are, of course, thanking all the princes worldwide who are standing up at this very critical time. And so it's coming up. But we have to understand why the crowns are so important. The crowns are so important. Yes, you may start with a Burger King crown. Who cares? It doesn't matter. You're declaring before heaven and earth and before all the demons that you have sovereignty.Members, Korean members, they don't have the right, the permission from the archangel to actually have weapons here. But they are making that symbolic gesture, right? That they stand in a kingdom that is not of this world. And that rod of iron will not be centralized and not be in the hands of the politicians and demons.But that the inheritors of the kingdom of God will have the authority of the rod of iron. So it is so important to have your crown. Uh-huh. And like I said on the Thursday, yes, the world may mock you and may laugh at you. Well, so what? They laugh at me too. I am the king that did not give away my crown. Do you know why? Because my father gave me. That would dishonor him. Yes. See, I did not give away my crown. Father, my father gave me the crown as the King of Kings to wear. So I didn't honor him by casting it off. I kept the crown. But then I am also the king that gave you also all you crowns too. So I didn't dishonor my father. I kept my crown. But I also gave you crowns. So when you come before the, you know, especially when we have the special events, and you're honoring the King of Kings, you must come and honor the hand that has crowned you too. There's a line. It's connected right to the top. Okay? So your crowns represent that sovereignty. The archangels cannot take. You know, we're having a wonderful time at Hunduke with the young, with our kids. And it's interesting, we're going through the Chinese Constitution. We just read the authority of the king section. And it's great because our kids can discuss it, and the third king is sitting right there too. So he hears this, and he has to understand what the Constitution, what he has to represent, and then you know, stand up and protect. And then it, also the other kids understand, oh, yes, the king's role. You know, I asked all the kids, what would happen if second king gave a third king all unlimited authority? And they're all sitting there like, looking at him. He's like, he's hiding under the backpack. I said, well, he become a demon. Because absolute power will corrupt absolutely. So I was explaining to my kids, your daddy is a king who knows that. And he knows that only the King of Kings can handle that. And so that is why in the Chinese Constitution with Cain and Abel, you have the balance of power. And you have the king in the connected with the judicial branch. Okay, not how the satanic kings control everything, including the force and the military and centralize everything. That's all broken down. Okay, and we went through the different section on the king. And that's why even the king, and I asked the question, can the king of Chinigook do this? Can the king of Chinigook do that? Can the king of Chinigook make this law? Can this king of Chinigook make that law? Can the king of Chinigook say you can't cut down trees in your backyard, private property, etc.? And this kind of exercise, having the children understand what kind of king is so important. Understand the Chinigook Constitution. When you do your hunduke with your kids, you can have Q&A. You can ask them questions. You relate to them the culture and civilization of Chunyugu. What you represent. And yes, your crowns may be like that now. As time goes by, I said to Mr. Chun, next time he has to come with more real assets on his crown. As time goes, these will become beautiful crowns. And we were talking about the Chinese culture. You don't see another crown say, look at this selfish person. Nice crown, better than mine. You don't do that. You say, wow, that person has a wonderful, beautiful crown. They're giving honor to the King of Kings. And they're coming before the three kingships and the altar of God. And they're showing the beautiful crown. And Father is so happy. And thank God for that kind of beautiful crown. Now that inspires me to upgrade my crown. You see what I mean? You don't be in this jealousy cult where you're saying, he has more expensive crown than me. Look at that person. No. We're happy when another blessed family can stand up in sovereignty. And while Erikawa Kaicho has her diamond crown, although it's not diamond. It's not real diamond. But in the future, it will be. You see? So all the culture of Chinigook and your civilization that you are inheriting, you also teach your children. You invest in the dynasty that's connected to the King of Kings. Yes. You don't just spend and waste things on frivolous things and then die in debt slavery.
You invest into your dynasty that get connected. The dynasties that were honorable and stood with the King of Kings and the three kingships. You invest in your dynasty, protect your dynasty. Then you train your children not to become arrogant, selfish, narcissistic money grabbers who want to steal your assets. No! Teach them in the culture of and teach them in the culture of peacefully people militia and teach them in the culture of the warrior spirit. Right? Honoring the loyal kings and queens that come before them. Protect the Constitution of God. Protect the kingdom. Right? Then they learn that culture, and as they go down, then they also are producing beautiful crowns, and that continues to go on for a generation. Then your dynasty can rise. Stand together with other dynasties that you're not jealous of, but you're thankful for, because we all stand together as a peace, police, peace militia, guarding as the guardians of this earth and of the cosmos, the children of the King of Kings and inheritors of the kingdom of God. SOS, come on up. It is with that in mind that we will, let's all rise and give the King of Kings the glory. I did not give away my crown. I did not dishonor my father who gave, put a crown on my head. Did not dishonor him. I kept my crown and then I gave you yours. So don't be shy of it. Embrace the sovereignty that has been handed down to you. Just like I had to embrace it too. Yes, I was shy of it first. I had to go through the same thing. This is the problem with good people. They don't want to be, you know, they don't want to, you know, raise themselves. I completely understand that heart. You all saw me have to go through that too. But it's not arrogant if you're proclaiming the truth. So it's not arrogant when I say I'm second king and I was crowned by the king. I didn't choose that. That was done. It was bestowed upon me. So it's not arrogance when I say what is true. That's a big difference. So it's not arrogance when you say I am a king and queen of Chanigu. I am a king and queen that represents my entire dynasty in Chanigu. And I stand with the King of Kings and his living kingship. We are one, peace, police, peace, militia. Now it's worldwide, spreading worldwide. And we have the Constitution that is right there. Understand it, read it, share it, discuss it with your family, your children. Understand the civility you've been given in the culture, a powerful culture of God that is now yours. Not so we can destroy it and have an ego trip, no. So we can preserve it and we can guard it for the sake of all humanity. Come on, SOS, come on up, come on. Is that it? Okay, what's this handsome man doing? Go ahead.
Okay, so before we get started with the regular praise and worship, we have a sister here that would like to give an offering song. We have Yoshika Kataoka from Yamaguchi Sanctuary Church. She was just blessed this past spring and she is here with her husband and mother. And today is also day. So let's please welcome up Mrs. Yoshika Kataoka.
Iman Thank you. So if we could all rise, let's offer praise to God together, everyone. Shiro's originals. We performed it before. As we sing this song, it really reminds me about, you know, Hyungjin's talking about the crown problem. So if we're on the King of Kings boats, we should be kings and queens in our own right to be on his boat, be on the boat of the King of Kings. So let's all join together and go on that boat and sail with our King of Kings.
till the break of day. La la la, hey la la la, oh la la la, hey. La la la, hey la la la, oh la la la, hey. Spending the day with my father underneath the clear blue sky. Spending the day underneath my father's loving eye. And we were laughing, singing away. And we were laughing and dancing and singing until the break of day.
As I sing praise songs, I always like to think of it as a cathartic experience. I like to take whatever emotions I'm dealing with or whatever, you know, is going on in my life, and I like to offer it up to God. And I like to really kind of think of my spirit, you know, through the music, transcending and kind of going to the place where God is and meeting Him there and offering everything up to Him. So as we sing this, offer everything up to Him that's in your lives and give Him all the glory.
Thank you. heart on the wire, hand in the fire for so long. But you showed me better, a new kind of love. It's ever the one I want. I'm lifting you higher, higher. There's nothing that I'd rather do. A sweet elevation of praises. There's no one I love more than you. I never knew a love like this before. The kind of life that I cannot find on my own. I've seen the world, but I had never been so sure. But I want your heart, God, I just wanna be where you are. Where you are, I just wanna be your love. Like nothing I've seen, my wildest of dreams don't come close. And I've never known better than living like this. I cannot resist you, Lord. I'm lifting you higher, higher. There's nothing that I'd rather do. A sweet elevation of praises. There's no one I love more than you. I never knew a love like this before. The kind of life that I cannot find on my own. I've seen the world, but I have never been so sure.
Say
compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. Death could not hold you, the field tore before you, you silenced the boast of sin. Praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
You wake within me, you're
하나님 왕권 수립 승리 어 만세 만왕 왕 전진 왕권 어 만세 천일국 창건 어 만세 아주 아멘 아주 hug your neighbor thank you dear thank you